Chicago. In 1812, Indians massacred 86 soldiers at Fort Dearborn. In 1871, Mrs. O'Leary's cow kicked over a lantern and Chicago burned, killing an estimated 300 people. 1927, Al Capone ended a week-long spree with the St. Valentine's Day Massacre. Total body count, 29. 1958, Our Lady of the Angels Catholic School burned due to arson. 92 students and 3 nuns, crisp. 1969, the Chicago Cubs. Countless casualties. If it weren't for Laura, I'd be there.
Laura arranged it so they could rehearse here.
Great.
Where is Laura anyways?
Still haven't seen her. Hey, do you know how I can get in touch with her friend Natalie?
You know Natalie?
Not yet. I gotta talk to her.
I know where you can find her. She lives in Hollywood.
Hi, Clyde.
Natalie?
Where's Laura?
I haven't seen her. That's why I'm here.
Oh, come on in.
Thanks. When was the last time you talked to Laura?
A couple of days ago. She called me from Vegas. She was flying pretty high, all that money and stuff. It's about time something good happened to her.
Something has happened.
What sort of trouble is she in now?
Every sort.
Is it Nick?
Nick Ritz?
What kind of game is he playing on her now?
He's holding her somewhere.
Holding her like what, hostage?
Yeah, something like that.
Was she okay?
He claims the money's his. He says she stole it from him.
That's typical. And what does he expect her to do? Just hand it to him?
I don't think she has it. Apparently she gave it to some guy named Rad.
Well, that would figure. He's her agent.
He's dead.
What's going on?
I'm not sure. Who's this Nick?
Just some slime ball. He came into LaMode about 3 months ago. I spotted him as soon as he walked through the door. Ponytail, bad suit. A real schmoozer. Talked a lot about seven-figure deals and great sex, but probably doesn't know much about either one. I tried to tell Laura.
Agent?
No.
Producer.
Yeah.
Studio?
Independent. Action pictures, you know, guy with a gun, girl with a wet t-shirt, girl without a t-shirt.
Watch me go get discovered.
About a month later, Nick gave her a deal, and Laura quit her job at LaMode. I didn't hear from her until last week when she called me from Vegas and told me she was a millionaire.
Half a millionaire.
Ha!
Is there any chance Laura didn't win the money?
What do you mean by that? Laura's no thief. She's an actress. And you're a cousin. She trusts you, Clyde.
She trusted Nick.
It's not fair. It could have easily been me. I never liked the guy, but this town runs on guys like Nick.
So where do you draw the line?
You don't. Once you draw the line, you're no longer an actress. You're a waitress. I'm not a waitress, Clyde. And neither is Laura. I know Strange, but it's what we believe.
Not strange, but I'm not here to pass judgment.
Why are you here?
Would you have any idea what Rad would have done with this money?
Well, he had a partner, Alakazar. Allie would have known if Laura gave Rad $5, let alone $500,000.
How do I find him?
I'll take you there tomorrow. He likes me.
You gotta check this out. Come on, come on.
Come on, Bob, I'm shape.
I know. Just one minute. Come on.
I can't even shave.
It's a miracle of life.
It's so unbelievable. It's truly wonderful.
Right here in Hollywood.
Right in our house.
Right in my suitcase.
I know.
Those are all my clothes.
Al-Khahira, Marsir al-Khahira. In 969 AD, Gorhar took Egypt. The city of Mars. Look, you'll see. The city, look. Al-Khahira with a kh.
Ali, are you all right?
It had been a tough week for agents. Rad had cut his last deal, and his partner, Alakazar, was a wrap.
Say it slowly.
No wonder these girls are waitresses.
Rose. Etty.
Rose. Etty?
Etty, yeah.
Rose Etty.
Yeah. You know?
No. What about Rad? Do you know who?
Oh, she's yeah, Rad.
Was it this Rose Etty?
Yeah.
And the money?
The money. Yeah.
What can you tell me about this Rose Etty?
What do you need to know? Cosmo Rossetti's a loan shark. He spends most of his time in Vegas, so I doubt you'll see him. There's a guitar shop on Sunset that he uses as a front. If he has the money, that's where it will be. Only one guy is there, Dimitri. He handles everything from the back room.
The mafia. The police want me for murder, and I'm staking out the mob? What am I doing? I've just got to keep this in perspective. Think about the Navigato's grandfather. The mob tried to hit that guy 18 times, and they never got him. He lived to be 89. Then again, he did die at that picnic eating corn on the cob when his bridge work lodged in his windpipe.
Guess I'll be going guitar shopping tomorrow.
So, you have a plan?
You just heard it.
Sounds diabolical.
What, you don't think I can do it?
Shop for a guitar?
Seriously, you don't think I can do it, do you?
Do you? What are you gonna do? Case the joint and then quietly blow up the safe when no one's looking?
Something like that.
I don't know, Clyde.
Hey, don't worry about it. This is not a problem. No problem.
Rad used to like to say that, too.
Listen, when I was 6 years old, my dad took me to my first Cubs game. They were playing the Braves. I remember in the fourth inning, we went to the men's room. place was filled with just these enormous men. Everybody's telling dirty jokes, and I didn't get any of them, but I laughed anyway. And then some guy in the corner started mooing like a cow, and everybody laughed. Pretty soon the whole place is mooing and laughing, and by the time I got to the front of the line, I was so nervous I couldn't go. I could feel my father behind me, and I became so ashamed I started to cry. I just stood there crying, and finally I just faked like I was done and ran out. I don't think my father ever even noticed, but it was all I could think about for the rest of the game.
That's it?
No, that's not it. Later that night, I had this dream. I was in this enormous men's room. The place was packed. My father was there, the Cubs were there, in their uniforms. I'm standing around this giant hole. And all of a sudden, all the talking stopped. I looked up, I noticed everybody was watching me and waiting. But it was really weird because it was like, I wasn't scared or nervous at all. And, you know, when I'd finished going, everybody started cheering. All the Cubs came up and patted me on the back. And my father smiled. And then the next morning, I woke up, changed my sheets, and everything was okay.
Well, that explains it all.